In this video, we're going to discuss the important concept called the base error. In practice, often obtaining a perfect classifier is impossible. Imagine we're trying to predict a disease using features from a blood test. Why can we never get a perfect classification in this case? Well, first of all, we might not have enough information. Maybe we need more medical tests to determine if a patient has a particular disease. Also, a feature like a blood test is never perfect. There can be some noise or randomness. Sometimes the blood test gives a faulty result. Therefore, we cannot perfectly classify a disease given only the blood test. In this case, we say there is class overlap. Look at the two probability densities of healthy and sick people in this slide. The y-axis indicates how likely it is to find an object from each class. The healthy class occurs mostly on the left side, and we see that the sick class occurs mostly on the right side. But for people in the middle, we cannot reliably say if they are sick or healthy. This is what we call class overlap, because here the two probability densities are overlapping. So how does this relate to the base error? First, let us define the base error. The base error is the best possible error rate that you can achieve given the features. This is a theoretical quantity because finding a model that has the smallest error possible is a very difficult task. But sometimes we can estimate it in a simplified example, as we will do now. Say we are trying to classify fruit using a single feature, the weight. To get this feature, we round the weight to tens of grams, or with other words, we use bins. This corresponds to the histogram on the right. This histogram is the only information that we have. Now the question is, estimate the base error using the histogram on the right. Given this histogram, we are going to try to find the best possible classification rule, and then we're going to determine the error of that rule. Please pause the video and try to do this for yourself. Okay, welcome back. Let us discuss the answer. First, we need to find the best classifier given the information that we have. The optimal thing to do in this case, for the histogram, is a majority vote for each bin. This is the histogram classifier rule. In this case, that means the four leftmost bins are classified as tangerine, the bin between 70 and 80 grams is undecided, and on the right we classify the bins as tomato. Now we can estimate the error rate for this classifier. This model makes 4 mistakes, and there are 22 objects in total. So the error rate is 4 over 22. This is our estimate for the base error for this problem, as this is the best model that we could construct given the features of this histogram. Okay, let's summarize this video. Why is it not possible to make a perfect classification? Well, that is because of noise in our data and because we might not have information. In this case, we get that the classes overlap. The base error is the error rate of the best possible classifier. In case of class overlap, the base error will be non-zero.